Herkese merhaba. In today's video, we are going to learn how to say I am, you are, and he, she, it, is. Tamam mı? So, let's get started with ben, sen, o. Ben is ben, ben, I, sen, evet sen, you, o, he, she, and it. You know, we don't have genders in Turkish. So, we have only o. O for three of them. And how do we distinguish that that if the subject is he, she, or it? We do it. We do it thanks to the context. It's not that difficult. So when we start learning English in primary school, we were shocked that you guys like somehow distinguish like people with gender. So we were really surprised that you specify if a person a woman or man. So it was really surprising for us. So it might be also surprising for you if you learn Turkish when your native language is those languages have feminine, masculine, and neutral cases, but we don't. So you're lucky about that. Let's see how we say I am. I am. Well, we do this with suffixes, like we use these suffixes like I am, im, ve im. For you, it's sen, sın, sin, sun, ve sün. For o, you're lucky again. There is nothing. Tamam mı? Şimdi bakalım. Birkaç örnek yazalım. Evet, I spoke Turkish. It happens and it will happen. I will try to make you get used to hear those words we learned in former videos. Tamam mı? Ben. Ben. Hasta. Is it this way? No, it wouldn't be this way. Because it's a suffix. It should be... They should be together. But in Turkish, you know, we always find an easier way to pronounce. We even have helper sounds. Yeah, helper sounds. What are they? Let's see them. In this case, the helper sound is ye. We have ye as a helper consonant to avoid to pronounce ben hasta ım, ben hasta ım, we wouldn't do this way. So to go on, to avoid the obstacle, we say ben hastayım, which means I'm sick. Tamam mı? Ben hastayım, not ben hasta ım. Always remember, if a word ends in vowel and if the suffix is beginning with a vowel, you will need a helper sound. Tamam? Ben hastayım. Hastayım. So what was the suffixes? For ben, for I am. İm, ım. So why it's but not ım? The explanation is we try not to move our lips much. It's a fact. We really avoid. Turkish is a such language that you actually speak like kind of in front of your mouth. Like it's always like blah, blah, blah, blah. Not. We don't have like glottal sounds. Like you can actually speak only with your mouth. I mean lips. So, So in this context, let's imagine I say ben hastayım. Ben hastayım. Hastayım. No, I wouldn't do this. I would avoid this, and I would use this form to avoid moving my lips. Ben hastayım. Hastayım. It's straight, right? This way, it's straight. But with this, hastayım, it doesn't even match. It doesn't even follow the vowel harmony. So we actually had only two options here. Please watch the vowel harmony video. So otherwise, it wouldn't make sense at the very beginning. Tamam? Hasta, we have, according to the vowel harmony, A, Ü, O, U, E, I, Ö, Ü. They are in different group, right? So the hasta ends in A, so it would be followed by either or um, but not im or um, because hasta is from this group, but not this. So the suffixes that hasta will take should be from this group, which is kalın. Remember, kalın, ince. So hasta ends in a, so the suffix is either a or u. But what did we say? We said we try not to move our lips much. So hastayım, hastayım. No, it sounds me weird. Tamam? So it's hastayım, hastayım. I will explain this better in upcoming videos. But let's keep this in mind, like we try not to move our lips. Tamam mı? But that's the reason actually. Evet, ben hastayım. Ben güzelim. I'm beautiful. Ben değil, not me. Ben güzelim. Güzel is beautiful. Güzel is beautiful. Did you notice I say güzel, güzel, like open E, not güzel, güzel. Yeah, that's what we do. We have two E sounds in Turkish, which is A and E, but we only have one letter for that. So you might come across with this, like when it's a root, when it's the base, the word itself, like güzel, but when it takes a vowel, I mean a suffix beginning with a vowel, it might change, like güzelim, not güzelim, but güzelim. You will come across this. So if you cannot pronounce a, and if you're not really familiar with when to use a and when to use e, just go for e, and nobody will judge you. Nobody will ask you, what did you say? Nobody will pretend this way, because everybody will understand. We even have this in our dialects. Tamam? So feel free. If you are at the very beginning, go for e, only like e. Tamam mı? Let's see. So, güzelim, ben güzelim, I'm beautiful. So what were our options here? It's either güzelim or im, right? But not or im, because güzel ends in e, which is ince. So the suffix it will take should be from this group. So, but güzelim, I moved my lips too much. It's over moving. Tamam mı? So we say güzelim, ben güzelim. Evet. Bakalım. Ben I don't want to say I'm ox, but it's the only word comes to my mind. Ben öküzüm. Öküz is ox. Ben öküzüm. Ben öküzüm. Evet, özür dilerim. I'm sorry. Ben öküzüm. Öküz is ox. Öküz ends in ü, so it is followed by but not öküzim. Tamam? Ben öküzim. Yanlış, incorrect. Ben öküzüm. Tamam? Because it ends in round, should be followed with round, round, round. Öküz, ü, ö, ü, öküzüm. Evet. I really couldn't find any other examples, so I had to give this. I'm sorry about that, but it's this way. Ve doktor, I'm doctor. Ben doktorum. See? Ends in o, o round, followed by a round version form. Tamam mı? Ben doktorum. Tamam. Bakalım. Ben hastayım. I'm sick. Ben hastayım. We use helper sound here because we avoid to pronounce it ben hastaım. Ben hastaım. Something is wrong, right? But it should be like ben hastayım. Hastayım. Ben güzelim. See? We didn't use it at all. Why? Because it already ends in consonant and there is no two vowels come across like right after themselves, let's say. You got it. Like there's a here ending in a, which is vowel, beginning with a vowel. So there's this case is problematic. So ye is our life saver helping us. So we call it helper sound. Tamam? Hastayım. So there's no obstacle. I can really pronounce it easily, freely. Ben güzelim. I'm beautiful. Ends in consonant, so doesn't need any helper sound. So we can pronounce it without any hardship. Güzelim. Ben öküzüm. Özür dilerim. Ben öküzüm. I'm ox. Öküz. Ends in ü, so it's not öküzim. We don't move our lips. So ben doktorum. Not ben doktorum, because I would move my lips too much if I say doktorum, doktorum. What doktorum? Doktorum. Go straight. Tamam? Round, beginning with round, followed by round, and goes on with round. That's the case. Let's switch to other case, which is you are. Tamam? Evet. I thought about an example instead of an öküz, but I really couldn't find anything. So I will use a proper name with ö and ü. I mean, ending in ü. So let's see it. So we are going to learn now how to say you are. Tamam. So how do we say you? Sen. Sen. Sın, sin, sun, sün. Turkish. Turkish is all about harmonies. So if a suffix has a form with ü, for sure it has other four forms, other three forms too, like sın, ü, i, u, ü. Inside it, like im, um. Tamam? We didn't learn it yet, but for past tense, for example, du, di, du, du. And even other harmony, like consonant harmony, don't be afraid, okay? It's not complicated. It's not like full of rules, blah, blah. No, it's not that way. With Turkish, it's not that way. The most important case about Turkish is you're lucky because we don't have many exceptions. Even if we have exceptions, we still have the explanation for that. Tamam? So if you come across some exceptions and if you want explanation, ask me down below the comment section below like iPhone says. Just ask me and then I will I might make a video for that if I find it problematic to understand for all learners, and if it's or maybe I mean I would even reply, you know, under the comment section. So yeah, shortly just ask me, okay? I will explain if I know. I hope I would know. Evet, So, sen öküzsün. You are ox. Let's use a proper name for it. Özgür. Özgür means özgür. Huh. By the way, in Turkish we mostly have meanings. I mean, the surnames, names have meaning. We really pay attention to name our kids with meaningful names. Like, we really care about the meaning. Like, it's not like, yeah, this is my name, but I don't know the meaning. We mostly know it. Tamam. So ask us. It would be an interesting topic to talk. Özgür means free, free man. Bakalım. Sen özgür. Which one? Evet. Özgürsün. Why? Because ü is round, so it should be followed with round form. Tamam? Özgürsün. Sen delisin. You're crazy. Sen delisin. Deli is crazy. Delisin sen. Sen delisin. Delisin. Why? Because e is ending. Deli is ending in e. Tamam? Sen delisin. Veya sen güzel. Sen güzel. Sin ends in e followed with e. Tamam mı? Because with other forms it wouldn't work. It would be hard to pronounce, or it wouldn't match the vowel harmony, the basic one, like a, ü, o, u, e, i, ö, ü. Remember from 2 minutes ago? Evet, güzelsin. Sen özgürsün. You're sick. Sen hastasın. Like, we use it like you're pathetic. Like, sen hastasın. Hastasın sen. So as you can see, sometimes like we put the sen at the end of the sentence. I'm not trying to confuse you, but I just want to give what I know, want to give the details. Like, if you come across, don't be like, hey, what the hell is happening? Like, why is it there? It's sometimes there, just to be poetic. Mostly you will come across to this in songs, and also when you're angry. Tamam mı? Evet, sen hastasın, güzelsin, delisin, özgürsün, doktorsun. Sen doktorsun. O followed with u form. Tamam, sen doktorsun. What Tarkan says. Sen başkasın. Do you know this? Sen başkasın means you're something else. Başka is else, like we use it in some context, like what else? Like başka? Başka bir şey? Is there anything else? So it means else. Sen başkasın is like you're something else. Tamam? Evet. This is basically what it is. One clue about that. I forgot about this clue. With ben. Ben So what's the clue? If you can't remember that, if you're a new learner, remember that ben begins with a sound like, okay, you remember ben, but you cannot remember this. Remember that it's something with you do, you pronounce it with lips, like ben, ben, ben. Öğrenciyim, I'm student. Ben öğrenciyim, ben hastayım. Tamam mı? Ben, tamam. Bu şekilde, this way. And this, when it comes to this, sen, sın, do you see? It sounds familiar, right? Yes, because centuries ago, this suffix, it wasn't a suffix yet. It was a separated word, like this subject. Sen, it could have been like sen, it used to be, let's say, sen özgürsen. It was like this. And then with time, we added this and we made it a suffix. Tamam? So it comes from sen. So keep it in mind this way. Sen, sin, sun, sun. If you remember sen but can't remember this, do it. Use this clue. It comes from sen. Tamam mı? So let's see now. How to say he is, she is, it is. Tamam? Evet. So, o hasta. Kim? Kim? Kim is who? Kim hasta? Kim hasta? O hasta. O hasta. O kim? O kim? Evet. O kim? Like who's that? We know it only thanks to context. So it might be confusing at the very beginning, but it's not a big deal. Come on. So in this context, according to the context, it can be he, she, or it. Tamam mı? So we have only one o. And there is no suffix at the end. So one clue about this, like ben, b, like lips, sen, sın, sin, sun, sun already comes from sen, and like they kind of sound similar, right? So this with the clue is like this. You see o, you remember this. It's like this, tamam mı? But there's o here, but imagine it like this. So let's do it this way. Don't be confused. Tamam. O hasta. O doktor. O hemşire, nurse. O güzel. She is beautiful. It is beautiful. He is beautiful. We don't know. But you know, thanks to the context. Tamam mı? If we talk about someone or something, o güzel, like a beautiful, you can say beautiful for things as well, right? So the same, like it's all about context. Tamam. This is what it is basically. I hope you enjoyed the class. If you have a demand, like if you really don't understand one specific case, just ask me. Just don't hesitate at all, because I already struggle to find subjects to help. So just ask me in the comment section below, and I might make a video, or I would just basically answer your question. Tamam? İzlediğiniz için teşekkür ederim. Thank you for watching. I hope to see you in another video. Görüşürüz.